want to ask you how has your day been by far? How do you feel today? How's everything around you?
Everything's good. You know, when your mind is good, everything is good. You know, it's a mind. When you're not good in your mind, then whatever happens, अच्छे से अच्छी चीज़ भी होगी, तो ऐसा लगेगा सब खराब है. You know, so luckily my mind is good. It's in balance. It's shaped up. Feeling you know, good about life.
I was going through your TEDx talk, you know, and I heard this line come out from you that you said you felt the poorest when you were materially the richest. And that hit me hard. And I want to know if you could elaborate a little bit about that feeling and why would one feel that way?
You know, normally one thinks that when they earn more money, when they have a bigger house, when they get richer, when they have, of course, fame. Not everyone's thinking of fame, but they have money, right? And of course, for me, as a young girl, I wanted independence. So I have independence. And after all this, if I start to feel not good, what is wrong? Right? And that's what starts to happen to me because everything was perfect. I mean, I was a super success more than I'd even thought I'd ever be, you know? And I had everything in the world. I had independence, I was living life my own terms. I was dating whoever I wanted. I wanted to live with a guy, I lived with a guy. You know, I smoked, I did whatever I had to do, right? In public, and I would walk alone and, you know, drive alone and, you know, everything, right? And fame, I mean, after Aashiqui was like, everybody loved me. I had millions of letters coming in, you know? I mean, what is then, what is the reason for me to not feel good? What is it, right? Obviously. I started wondering, and I was a happy child before that, you know. I was always happy, I'd like smile and move on, you know. After becoming famous, I started getting depressed. I was like, ye kya ho gaya? What happened to you? You know, so fame is very difficult to handle. I mean, and Bollywood is a difficult place to handle. You know, and you have seen Sushant's case, you know, it is difficult.
Yeah.
And as outsiders, it's very, very, very difficult.
Right.
But my savior was fame. My savior was success. And I think when you have success, nobody can touch you, you know?
Absolutely. And you look happy today, and that's a wonderful thing. Also, like now you just spoke of Sushant Singh. Now that we know that the CBI inquiry is on, so now that the entire nation, you know, prayed for the solace, how do you feel when people stand up for one person altogether?
You know, it's such a tragic case, yeah. I mean, if people didn't stand up for Sushant, it would be surprising. Because I mean, a young guy, come on, you know, and you see his, like, from what is seen, I mean, I never met him. But, you know, from what is seen, he looks like a happy guy, he's an intelligent fellow, from what things understand, you know. But, you know, all children have a family, at the end of the day. I mean, family pe kya guzarti hai, yaar. Mujhe khud pata hai, mera jab accident hua hai na, so what my family went through, my mother cried every day, you know. So, and doctors are telling ki she will live only for 3 years. When I left the hospital on a wheelchair, meri halat hi khasta thi ekdam. I couldn't even walk, you know. I had to be lifted, you know. My half my body was paralyzed. But what I'm saying is that parents, family, the close ones go through the worst time.
Yeah.
And I think that we all understand that. And, you know, our good wishes always and our feelings always go out to them. Even in Sushant's case, whatever it was, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that this is like, come on. You know, it's not a banta hai logon ka, but yeah. I don't know if anything should be blown out of proportions, because it could be blown out of proportions by the media sometimes, you know. And, you know, case na, case se kuch nikal ke aana chahiye, wo worse nahi ho jaye. You know, things shouldn't get worse and worse and bad for even people who are concerned. Because everybody has a life, yeah. Galtiyan sabse hoti hain. Ab jisko jana tha, wo to chala gaya. But baki jo log the, wo to yahi rahenge na. You know? So, I think that there should be a consideration for all those people who are involved as well, I feel.
Also, ma'am, talking about your accident, I also heard of brain bleeding, I heard of ruptured bladder and what not. And, you know, we have somebody who's actually gone, seen death and come back in front of us. Now, I'm going to talk like this because I have also been, you know, in a very big accident. I have a rod in my hand, a rod in my leg, and the doctors told me that I won't be able to survive. But now here we are together talking. But I still sometimes get those, you know, those visions of those times. Does that happen to you too? Do you feel that way sometimes?
Yeah, that used to happen to me, you know, in the first, because up to, it's been 20 years. 1999
mein hua tha.
Ji. So, but in the first few years, yes. I used to have dreams, I used to have visions. I would have a dream that, you know, I was lying on a hospital bed. Everything was white, you know, the sheet was white, the people were walking in white, you know, and everything was in slow motion, you know. Because somewhere I'm also an actor, right? So, there's a scene that visually like a scene, you know, like a scene would play. And they would be injecting me with all kinds of things, you know. Like, you know, all sorts of things used to come, but I wouldn't feel pain. I would come out of it. You know, so I had like positive somewhere because I was training my mind to look at things positively, you know. So whatever visions I had also would have a positive ending, you know, and slowly, slowly, slowly the visions stopped. But it took many years. Yeah, definitely. When did you have yours?
I had this accident in 2008. So maybe I'll take another more years, another few years to heal from this. Also,
but
ma'am.
No, you have healed very well. You have healed very well. I can see that.
But ma'am,
and also, I will teach you Anupan Yoga. Huh? Whatever jo kasar baki ho, usse puri ho jayegi.
Seriously. Yeah. Also, yeah. Ma'am, you came back in 2014 and you were the first person to, you know, bring International Yoga Day in 2014 to India. And that's how you came back with a bang. So are we going to see all of this and all of these tidbits that we know about in your book that is coming?
Yeah, you know, okay. The book that is coming is a little different in the sense that I think it's very important that I talk about what is the closest to me.
Yes.
Because writing is also healing.
Right.
When you write about something or you talk about something, then, you know, you overpower it, you know. That's why writing is amazing. You should also write. Start writing and even 2-3 lines about just what you are feeling, you know, every night. Make it a habit. It's fantastic. So, yeah. So the second book, I thought like, what has like death, how I've been through death? And, you know, what am I learning? And what can people learn from it? You know, what is it that human beings are lacking somewhere? You know, they're not understanding some things. I want to bring, because I was not understanding them before this incident happened with me. So how did it change me and how it can change people and get them a more successful life, you know? It's all about the people. When you're writing a book, anything I do in public is about the people, you know? And I want to better people's lives as much as I can. I feel that that's my mission and I feel that's what I'm back for. Otherwise, मैं उसी दिन चली गई होती है. मेरी जो हालत हो गई थी ना, Even doctors say that it's a miracle that you even survived that. Even in a coma for 29 days, they thought that she'll never wake up. You know? But I've been brought back for this work, to get all of you better in life.
Absolutely.
So that's what the book is about, yeah.
Also, talking about spirituality, ma'am, everybody has a different take on it unless, you know, you're aware of it. So people who are not aware would probably think, pahadon mein chale jao, ya probably chanting kar lo, ya probably yoga kar lo. But what is the self-understanding and that process that, you know, takes for someone to be spiritual? What is it according to you? How did you happen to be like this?
You know, the thing is that there is a very simple fact which people forget. And that simple fact is that we are spirit first. And we are a body or a human being later. We are firstly born as a spirit. So if you see in the womb of a mother, it's a spirit that enters. And then 3 months, so this is a big study, and this is another book I'm working on. 3 months later, so the sex of the person is not when the spirit enters the womb. We don't know the sex. The sex can be discovered only 3 months later. You know, it becomes a boy or a girl.
Yeah.
Right? And then that is its spirit level. I mean, you know, and then the body starts to form and, you know, slowly. It's a whole process that happens. But the birth is as, and we are all born from as spirits. Right? Because we entered, all of us have entered our mother's womb. Right? And that's how we are here.
Absolutely.
So we are spiritual. We are spiritual before material. But our material world catches us so much that we start to forget our spiritual self. And that's what the entire, you know, of any tradition, of any even religious traditions which go into like, okay, fine, chanting and let's go to temple and there's a God. But any tradition which is talking about anything which is about self-empowerment wants you to get back to your real self. And your real self is spiritual self. You have the ultimate power inside you. So that is the understanding that we all need. And I think that even yoga and, you know, meditation, all these things are just processes to accomplish that, to get back to your spiritual self. And that's what accident did to me. Because my body got broken, all that remained was the spirit. And I know from there that all I felt was love. All I felt was like towards everybody around. My face couldn't even move because everything was paralyzed. But I would lie there in bed. I had no idea where I was, what it was, what my name was. Nothing. But I, even like if I see like a lizard somewhere far away, I would start like conversing and sending love to that lizard. You know? Like anybody who entered my room, because people are crying and all that when they used to come to see me, ki kya ho gaya ladki ko, you know, that sort of thing. And I'd be filled with joy and love, you know, when I saw them. So what happened? This is what who, then I understood that this is who each one of us is this. But we have forgotten. So the tradition, the whole processes to remember that.
Yeah.
And that's what, you know, I think that even like with my own Anupan Yoga, I found this capsule of, you know, different traditions, of different ways to get to that point. And once we get to that point, we are all healthy and super and happy and all everything. But we need to get to that point of ourselves.
Absolutely. Very, very beautifully said, ma'am. Ma'am, I wanted all the audiences, like people are still your fans. It's not that people have forgotten you. They can never. And people would want to know a little more about your foundation. If you could elaborate, what is it about and what purpose does it, you know, serve to the world, if you could tell me?
You know what? I mean, the thing is that, so let us start with the fact that I'm actually a master's in social work. This is what I wanted to do when I was 15, 16. I just wanted to work for the people. And I just wanted to make everyone happy, as even as a child. What do you want to do? Like, you know, anybody would ask me when I was 3 years old, I want to make people happy. Mm-hmm. What does that mean, right? But even as a child, I would say that. And slowly as I grew up, it started to mature into this thing that I said, okay, let me study it. You know, so I studied social work, so how to do things for people, blah, blah. And now, after, you know, when I went through the accident. So, by the way, before that, I went into yoga. And for me, it gave me time to think and remember that, hey, you were a social worker, you became a film star. You know, and you almost like didn't think of that thing. But then I said, yeah, what is the difference? I said, okay, yoga is that you are studying how to better your inner self. And with social work, it was how to better roti kapra makan, you know, the outer thing. So I said, okay, yeah. So now this is like you are advancing on the level of how to make people happy. Okay. Finally, when I became, then suddenly now 99, I've had the accident. And then I started to get, and as I started to get better, I started thinking, I have to now start this. I have to share this with the people, you know. And how do I share it? So, dheere dheere, I started a research in 2014, in fact. So, World Yoga Day jab hua, usi time pe, I started working with an NGO called Akanksha. So they work with children, underprivileged children. And I started how to bring them joy, how to bring them happiness. So I called it Anu Fun, you know, that's why. And I wanted to see what the result, and they were like jumping and laughing and, you know, all the like really like depressed children sitting. Suddenly within a month, they are like, you know, everyone boosted up and, you know, you see the pictures, there are a lot of people who tell me, these are not slum kids. So I then say to them, exactly, kids are kids. They look like slum kids because their postures are like slum kids. That's how, and their faces are like that. But the minute they start jumping and playing around like you're normal kids, they are normal kids. You make them wear the dresses, they look like that, right? So anyhow, so then it started and slowly and gradually, I also, because I've been through such hardship, you know, physical hardship and such helplessness, you know, that like when certain parts of your body are not working, you know, what you go through, you know, and like my arm, my right arm was paralyzed. I know what difficulty I went through even, you know, eating or writing. I couldn't write with my right hand anymore. So I know these difficulties. So my heart started to go out to people who are facing difficulties. So then this thing became, okay, yes, this works with children. Then I said, okay, next thing, let me test it with cancer patients. So then I started, you know, doing like palliative care and doing things. And I started also recording this stuff, making abstracts and presenting them at international conferences. And luckily they invited me or they liked my work. You know, I worked a lot, but they liked it, and I would go and talk about it, you know, that this is what it is. And they were, it was amazing because I was there in Austin, Texas, in America. And I was talking about these slum children and the whole room filled up. They were like, for normal talks and lectures, there were like 10 to 15, 20 people. When I started talking about the slum children, all, there were like 200 people in that room. And they were so interested in knowing that how can you change, you know, how can yoga therapy change their life? So my foundation finally came about through all these researches that I did. And it came about in 2017, I registered it. And I know it's a lot of work because I have worked with NGOs. And I know there's a lot of fakeful ones, you know. The naam ke vaste they have put it, and you know. And I wanted it to be very because I'm not doing it for money. I made a non-profit. I'm putting my own money in it, you know, and I want to help people and truly want to do that. So slowly and gradually, we started this, Anupan, and we started teaching this. We also worked with the blind people, so on, so on. But you know what? Now with the COVID, we see that our focus has slightly changed because the needs of people are changing. Hunger, for instance, has become a huge problem. You have like hundreds and thousands of kids and people who are hungry right now as we talk. It pains my heart to think that. And I think like, how can we do something about it? So we are making a new website, in fact, now, as I'm talking to you. And we're putting in this new policy. Also, mental health is getting to be a huge problem.
Yes, absolutely.
You know, with like people, there are domestic problems. There are people who are having, you know, people are working out of home. It's not working. There is this uncertainty about COVID. People don't know what is going to happen. You know, all of these things. So we are starting some programs on mental health. I'm going to personally start some. I am really looking forward to that. But I'm trying to find the right way to do it. You know, it should reach the right people, you know, not just my fans. My fans, of course, you know, but also like the needy, you know, people who really need it. And, you know, we are working something for handicrafts, the women, you know, who are making these, like we have a project with Kota Sadis. Women who are making, they're all dying of hunger. They're so skilled, these people. So all these things are carrying on with the, I'm so glad that my foundation, because I am the boss, you know, I can change it according to what the need of the day is. Rather than saying, nahi, hum toh yehi karte hai, you know, nahi, aisa nahi hai. Whatever the society needs, whatever the community needs, the nonprofit should come out and do that. And I would like everybody to join. I want all of you to join. You, of course, are going to do Anupan Yoga to begin with for your condition. I'm going to make a program for you when COVID becomes.
And ma'am, like you just spoke about everything, the every single little sensitive thing that you're looking at shows how beautiful a person is inside and out, of course. But, you know, this is a very long debate going on from decades that, you know, fairness has got nothing to do with success. It's got nothing to do with beauty.
Yeah.
And now finally, this Fair and Lovely brand has decided to cut out the name called Fair from their brand. So was it a problem back in time? Because you've been a successful person. You've been a dusky on the duskier side, and so am I. And I can totally relate because a lot of people have told me, you know, ye kaun hai, ye kaun si anchor hai, kya hai?
Yeah.
People comment like that, you know, ye to kali hai. So, How do you, you know, deal with that and not let that affect you?
You know, it's like, you know, I'll tell you what. It's like your own, first of all, we have to accept ourselves.
Yeah.
The trouble is that we feel that it's not right. Then we get affected by what people are saying.
Yeah. Yeah.
But if we think it's right, so
coming back to
you know, if like I said to you that if I feel I'm good, who can tell me I'm not good? Whether it's true or not true, it's another question, right? But I think I'm hot, you know, I'm hot and I'm, you know, I'm like the cake. Okay, if I think that, then somebody says, oh, she's this, she's that. Also, he doesn't know I'm this. So, you know, it's all about, so, I mean, as far as my dark skin was concerned, you know, or the color, I was like, sorry, this is my color. What's wrong with you? This is natural. Yeah, yeah, I'm really sorry. If it doesn't match your expectations, go and find the circle. Simple as that, no? Why are you coming to me, yaar? Theek hai, main hoon jo hoon. Chhodo mujhe apne haal mein chhod do. Right? You go and search for this. There's enough fair girls around. So the entire thing is that it's about acceptance. And I would want all the girls who have, you know, who are dusty and who have been told, I want all of them to know this, that they are beautiful because they're natural. They're naturally, that color has, that is what has formed them. It has come naturally. So it's better than anything that can be artificial.
Yes.
And they're beautiful. And if anybody thinks otherwise, they can go and look for some other girls who are fair and all that. Forget about it. They're not for you.
Wow. And I'm going to, you know, behave exactly the same. Ki tu jana se ko kisi aur ke paas jana to mujhe pareshan mat kar. Also, ma'am, this is off the record a question. Like your co-star Rahul Roy from Aashiqui, you know, even he did not do a lot of films after that. And, you know, he just then suddenly landed up on Big Boss and he went on to win the show. So if given a chance and ever, if you were invited to do the same and be a part of a reality show, would you ever like to be a part of it?
You know, I mean, two things here. One of the things is I want to say that... you know, that each person, you know, I mean, it's like how a brother and a sister have different traits. You know, similarly, I mean, we were in the same film, but, you know, I left in any case. So, but, you know, he made whatever choices he did and it maybe didn't work out very well of the films that he did or whatever. But as far as Big Boss is concerned, they already came to me, they've been coming to me to come and join the Big Boss. And I declined because I was like, this is so unnatural. How can you put me in a room? This is totally unyogic, you know? And then you're going to like, I won't see the sun for like 1 month or something, out of question. You're paying me these crores and crores and crores of rupees. Keep it with yourself. I'm not going to come. So anyhow, who knows? I mean, आगे की किसने देखी है?
How do you see the films coming on the OTT platforms and everywhere nowadays? You know, when we see back in the 80s, the 80s and 90s, बहुत सारे फिल्मों में सिर्फ रेप सीन्स हुआ करते थे, लड़कियों को एक यू नो एक जरिया समझा जाता था. अभी वो चीजें बदल रही है. आपको कैसा लग रहा है? How do you see the changes? Is there anything that you want to speak on the content that comes out nowadays?
Well, I mean, you know, the thing is that, yeah, there is a difference. But then there's a difference in everything, no? We are like, the technology has changed. Technology has brought us the whole of the world, which we didn't know about.
Yeah.
You know? I mean, for instance, in 1995, when my film released in Cannes Film Festival and went to 40 different film festivals, there were people who said, yeah, Cannes kya cheez hoti hai? Literally, I'm telling you. You know, and you know, just like with technology coming late in the 90s and all, people have started understanding what the world is all about. Movies have also got these, you know, the corporates and started to enter the movie business. You know, that changed things a lot. Before that, it was the mafia who was running the movie business, right? In the 90s, 80s, 90s. The kind of movies that were coming out were very like, you know, they could be much better than what they were coming out, right? The kind of films that were made, the kind of characters there were. You know, like, for instance, I didn't want to ever do Hindi films because the girl was so silly, you know. She was just like a rich father's, you know, she was always a rich father's brat. And the boy used to be the struggling guy, you know. So there was no girls used to never struggle. You know what I'm saying? So Aashiqui, in that sense, brought a complete difference. So the girl herself is alone and she struggles. But yeah, there's differences, but you know what, we can get better. I don't see this is the end. I see, yes, we have become better, but you know, COVID has changed so many things. Now the way shootings are happening and all that. So the kind of movies that will come out when we don't have a set of 200 people,
yeah.
You know, now with the social distancing and all that, maybe only there'll be 20 people on set. So maybe we'll get more realistic. We can still be more realistic in the subjects that we bring out. Because how real are we? you know. Still, yes, we are bringing up subjects, and you know, it is good. It is good. We are, you know, bringing up certain important and real subjects, you know, and it should be on the rise. Yeah, definitely, I'm for that.
Yeah. Also, I'm trying to not be insensitive with this question, because you already told me like how fame got you a little sad in life. But now that you've overcome all of that, and now that you have control over yourself completely inside and mentally, spiritually, everywhere, do you now think that, you know, you would ever be able to or ever be ready to act yet? Ever?
Listen, I am a born actor. That's what my mother also says. So, I mean, forget about it. I love to act, because it's the most natural and the deepest thing that I can do, to work, to talk to a camera. For me, it's like amazing. One of the reasons I left movies was because of the business and the way it was, and a lack of really amazing directors. So I did some amazing work with some great directors, and there was hardly anybody more at that time, you know? So, of course, you know, of course. There are some talks are on. There are talks are on, couple of talks are on. And yes, definitely. You know, I mean, I know that for me, I mean, in each movie I did, there was the role was created for me. Khalnayika. Ashiki, I did. Mahesh Bhatt told me the movie, the script was created by around my character, my real life, a single girl who wants to be independent, you know, and becomes a Parisian model, right? It was my real life story.
Yeah.
Khalnayika was like it was based on a Hollywood movie, Hand That Rocks the Cradle. But I asked the director, he says, he showed it to a couple of like, you know, big actresses or whatever at that time, who are good actresses. And they said, Are, sab aap end change karo, kyunki heroine mar kaise sakti hai? You know, the girl dies in the end. And I told the director, I said, listen, are you crazy? Keep it. You promised me that you will make the film as it is. Then I'll do it. Otherwise, I don't want to do it. So he said, wow, kya ladki. He said, wow, kya. Aise to kisi ne nahi bola. Ye to modern ladki aaj kal ki. You know, iska dimaag chalta hua hai. He said ki, aise hi rakho. So, a character like in Mani Ratnam's film, that also got created. You know, so, I mean, the directors were looking at me and creating roles, and I was choosing roles. Out of 100, I chose one, literally. I stopped signing in 1993. 1995, this film released in Cannes, and I was out. So I am an actor, yeah. I'm an award-winning actor. So, I mean, of course. Of course. I mean, if there's something worth it, yeah. I've always been choosy about what I do. But if there's something amazing which can bring a lot of juice to the people, right? Why not?
Speaking to you makes me happy, you know. I'm going to be very honest about that. And also, I'm not going to take a lot of your time. I just wanted to ask you that all the viewers who are going to be watching this interview about you, your life, your journey, and upcoming stuff, what would you want to say to everybody?
I would just say to them, be happy. Forget about whatever shit happens around you, including COVID. You can come over everything in life. You just have to decide it. Decision, even happiness is a choice. So decide it for yourself. You'll have a better life.
Wow.
And come join me. Come join my causes. Help other people, because that's very healing.
Absolutely. And we are definitely here with you, ma'am. And like I said, that I'm going to be there for your yoga thingy after the COVID thing is done. I'm going to be in touch with you. I have your number. I'm going to make sure I stay in touch with you. And lastly, I hope you like this conversation.
Lovely. Thank you so much. It was a pleasure talking.